hot take is that he's going to win the dunk contest. Mark my words.
I'm in the trenches, relax. Can you not pedal a boy in the club? Because we do not listen to rest. We in Atlanta, I buy her wig. She telling me Tay is the best. Pointed at the who act like a killer, but you only one from the net.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back to our film breakdown. This week, we are doing Jaemyn Brakefield, the 6'8 power forward, native of Jackson, Mississippi. Went to Huntington Prep in West Virginia, where he was a three-time West Virginia Gatorade Player of the Year, recruited by Duke late in the game, choosing Duke over Auburn, Louisville, Ole Miss, and UCLA. Ritz, give us your first thoughts on what Brakefield's game looks like.
Look, I got to say, I love this kid's game. Even though he's a four-star recruit and may not be sort of starting for us this season, what a luxury to have his energy coming off the bench. This dude is all over the court. I mean, just look at the mixtape here that we have for you. It's going to be the one man fast break that he's powering. He can get his own shot, create his own shot. I mean, dunks inside, shots outside. Look, he finishes with the right, he shoots with the left. That's Eric, that's what we call ambidextrous.
Yeah, I mean, absolutely. He's you know, he's a very versatile player. You know, he demonstrates his shooting ability. You know, and he's athletic, and you know, he demonstrates defense. You know, and with the ball handling ability, he can kind of do a little bit of it all. I think it's going to make him a versatile asset, and you know, especially be able to get him in different parts of the lineup. He's going to be able to like stretch the floor a little bit and cause problems for some defenders.
Yeah, so Jaemyn fits in really well with this team. He is a big body. I think we mentioned he's 6'8", 216. So he's not someone that I expect to get bullied around by some of the bigger, older bodies in college. He was a top six power forward. So, you know, this kid's coming in with a lot of accolades, even if he was a four-star. And so he's going to have a lot of skill to bring to this team. Some had him ranked as 31 overall or 34 overall. Honestly, it doesn't really matter. And even with those lower rankings, some of these guys just have chips on their shoulders, which is really nice. So he might play with a little bit of an edge. In high school, he was averaging 19.2 points per game and 8.3 boards. So almost averaging a double-double, which is almost a bit of a prerequisite for some of these guys, especially with someone as much athleticism and defensive potential as Jaemyn brings. And then when he was on the AAU circuits and the EYBL circuits, he was averaging 16 points and 6 rebounds. So again, even when he's playing up against more of that elite competition, he's still able to get buckets and able to produce off the boards.
Yeah, actually named the West Virginia Gatorade Player of the Year 3 times in a row, sophomore, junior, and senior years. Apparently the only player to be to do that in 35 years. The other piece of the peach jam was that he actually played on Jalen Johnson's team, who we've already done the video segment for, so at least there's some chemistry here coming into the season between those two, so that will be very interesting to watch. Taylor, you've been looking at the draft potential for a lot of these recruits coming in. Give us your take on draft potential, and also, will Jaemyn stay for multiple years here at Duke?
Yeah, I definitely think Jaemyn is a multi-year player here at Duke. We know he wants to be here, signing, you know, his letter of intent one day after the offer was extended. So I think as he continues to grow and get bigger, unfortunately, I don't see him as a starter right now. So I think he'll need to earn that role more and earn Coach K's trust. And I think coming from that, he can be, you know, maybe a 2 or 3 year player and then eventually maybe turn into a first rounder.
I completely agree. He's going to be coming off the bench definitely for this first year. And I think he's going to have to fight to win some minutes. But because of his size and his athleticism and his ability to produce on both ends, I see him coming in, and if he gets minutes on the court, I think he's going to have a big impact, even against some of the more physical teams. But then, of course, I do expect him to be here for at least 2 years, maybe 3, just depending upon how things go for him.
I think it's important we know kind of this incoming versatile skill set that I think that's only going to develop, and you know, the weaker parts of that skill set are only going to get stronger. The classic 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is always getting stretched. That doesn't really mean anything anymore for most guys, and players like Jaemyn Brakefield like want to be not a pigeonholed 4 or 5. So I think he's already on the path to that, and I think that'll grow and develop, you know, probably with one more year at least at Duke. So
hot take is that he's going to win the dunk contest. Watch out for it. Mark my words. I got it right last year with Cassius Stanley. This year it's going to be Jaemyn Brakefield.